during the during the PI planning is people are calling out dependencies and risks. And I don't think people get the idea of risks and what a dependency is. A dependency is a risk. As a program manager, project manager for many, many years, always knew in all my schedules when I was dependent upon another group to give me something so my team could be successful. And that is a risk. A dependency, by definition, is a risk. Anytime you don't have control over something, it's considered risk. And it was kind of interesting how many people, when they go through the whole PI planning, and they're identifying their risks and their stuff, and they kind of ignore the dependencies, and they just glossed over it. And I was very like, well, that puts your whole plan at risk, your team at risk, delivering what you promised. And they just kind of like, oh, well, it's a dependency, it's not a risk. But it is a risk. Dependencies. Anytime your team depends on another team to give you something or to help you do it, it's definitely a risk, because you have to make sure that interchange. Because when you're in your team, at least you're talking every day. You're engaged with each other, theoretically, if you're running it right. So maybe you wouldn't talk about, like, if I'm the tester and I'm depending on my partner who's a developer to code it and then I'm going to test it, that's not a risk. That's just a handoff, right? There is some risk to it, but it's, you don't need to really watch it because you're watching it every day. And you got like 5, 6, 7, 8 people watching each other's risks all the time. But when you have a dependency, you really need to call it out. So one of my recommendations, when you do have external dependencies, you got 2 options. Well, you got lots of options. I'll give you 2, my take. So either you have a story in your sprint that someone on your team monitors. Some would say it should be the Scrum Master. I don't know. If it's a technical issue, I kind of like having a technical person in charge of the story and not a Scrum Master. Just to monitor and have that communication with another technical group out there that they're needing. A lot of times Scrum Masters don't know enough. Maybe you need a, you need a new container built up, or you need some container. I don't know. You may see some technical connections. You need to SAML or, different security assets clarification. Scrum Masters may not know that, but the technical person should know exactly what they need. And maybe they're a better person to have a connection with another group, but maybe a story. And then the other idea is that you create a story and you ask the person, the other group, to be a part of it. However, it messes up their tracking of their work and everything too. So I kind of like the idea of having a story in the sprint. Depends how much work it is to actually make sure it happens, whether or not you give it a point or not. Probably a point would be good, because then you can classify, hey, I'm doing some tasks. I want to follow up, a couple of times, or maybe do some trial stuff between what you're looking, what they're doing. So maybe you need a whole thing, but maybe you just need a little story. Says, I need to make sure this handshake works. So you create a task in there to do maybe a little tiny spike. So as they turn things on, you're verifying in a way and spending some time that actually all the data is coming through the way it is. So that's what I wanted to talk about for dependencies and risks. Any dependency outside a team is actually a risk and should be tracked and monitored. The Scrum Master can help out with anything they need to do. If the other group's not really working on it, Scrum Master should follow up and maybe go talk to their managers and say, hey, you're putting our work at a risk here because we're not getting that connection we needed from the other team. 47, we're late. Hey, we're going live. We're live. This is 5 a.m. Master Scrum. Hope you're doing well. It is Friday. Yay. So I don't know about some people, it's already done, the whole week's over. So good for you for overseas. This is episode 137 of the 5 a.m. Master Scrum Show. And here we talk about Agile and Scrum in a practical and tactical way so that you can get home to your family or friends quicker, faster, better, and also deliver software and products, not just software, but other things. And we talk about other things outside of software and IT to your customers quicker, faster, better, without the stress and the craziness, but also some fun. And we are going to do Fortune Cookie Friday. Got some fortune cookies yesterday. So